I'm just here to preach the gospel.
Okay.
Cool. Thanks.
Now give me that
old time religion.
Give me that
old time religion.
Give me that
old time religion. It's good enough for me. It was good for our mothers. It was good for our mothers. It was good for our mothers. It's good enough for me.
Now give me that
old time religion.
Give me that
old time religion.
Give me that
old time religion.
So what's going on with this video right now is we are doubling back to get off the exit called Sarah Lawn. We did a recon to see what would be the best exit to downtown Ottawa Red Zone on Sunday, February the 20th, 2022, the day after the police savagely beat up peaceful protests. But throughout the process of doing this, they had blocked off the exits. So what I would be doing in the video right now as you watch it is I would honk my horn at every single exit that I saw a cop outside just for a sign of freedom. Despite what the leftists think it is, it's not a salute to Hitler. It's a salute to freedom. When I first did this process, Matt was not a huge fan of my comedy. But after doing this several times, he slowly warmed up to it. I was definitely having way too much fun doing this joke. Sometimes you just have to have fun.
Oh, they're out. Perfect. Excellent. And it's a... Oh, they didn't even bounce. No.
So right now what you're watching is me and Matt leaving the parking lot from Timmy's. And we had to do some talking about our next plan after driving up road that we normally take to get down to Ottawa. We saw a checkpoint and Matt was feeling very uncomfortable proceeding. However, the Spirit of the Lord was weighing heavily on me to proceed. I just kept thinking of the Bible saying about being persistent. I told Matt that we will go ahead and try to make it through this checkpoint. And if we don't make it through, we will just have to try to find another way on foot. Now, I should definitely point out that it may not have been necessary to do with my persistent attitude. Maybe more so with the fact I didn't want to have to walk an hour away. Anyways, Matt reluctantly agreed with me. Plus, he really didn't have a choice because I was the one driving.
Makes me love everybody, makes me love everybody, makes me love everybody. It's good enough for me.
Now give me that
old-time religion.
Give me that
old-time religion.
Give me that
old-time religion. It's good enough for me.
Now we come to a very interesting part of the video. Watch how long it takes for the black pickup truck to go through the checkpoint. Also watch the police officer. They all of a sudden go into their cruisers, probably because they're tired of standing. Then you'll see us go through the checkpoint and see how fast it takes us to go through the checkpoint. Remember, we don't live in Ottawa. We live an hour away from Ottawa. They don't even ask for our license.
It was good for our fathers, it was good for our fathers, it was good for our fathers, it's good enough for me.
Now give me that
old-time religion,
give me that
old-time religion,
give me that
old-time religion, it's good enough for me. It was good for the Hebrew children, it was good for the Hebrew children, it was good for the Hebrew children, it's good enough for me.
Now give me that
old-time religion,
give me that
old-time religion,
give me that
old-time religion, it's good enough for me.
I'm just here to preach the gospel.
Okay.
Okay. Cool, thanks.
Here's the same move through a different camera. Matt was using my cell phone to film the interaction. I thought it was so cool and so funny because dealing with these officers in the past, with the past several weeks, every time you mention the word gospel, they are taken back to the point of not even understanding what the gospel means. But this officer may have grown up in a Christian family and knew some things about the word gospel, but point is, it was quite surprising. You can hear me laughing in the video because I was in shock, and Matt was in shock where he did not say anything for about a minute.
I'm just here to preach the, I'm just here to preach the gospel.
Okay.
Okay. Cool, thanks.
They don't care. Okay, she's probably thinking, yep, good, we need him.
Matt finally said something about this, and this was the moment he does, and he was quite shocked.
Weird. That's crazy. Like, all of a sudden they get in the car, they're like, I don't even care. She's like, I don't even care about this. Isn't that funny? Jeez, you can probably find that little parking spot. Yeah.
It was good for Paul and Silas. It was good for Paul and Silas. It was good for Paul and Silas. It's good enough for me.
Now give me that.
So I have to stop the video for a second again. Unfortunately, the camera that I have been using was my body camera. This was a camera that was not very expensive. Therefore, the old saying goes true, you pay for what you get. For whatever reason, unknown to me, the camera was pointing up when I thought it was pointing straight. So it does miss some critical parts, but you can still piece it together to get the general idea of what's going on. Like, there's definitely not a police presence. I was talking to Matt about filming the Great Ottawa Wall and how stupid this whole thing is, but Matt was actually quite nervous and did not want to get too close to the Great Ottawa Wall because there was a cop cruiser in front of the wall. Where I personally did not care, this is not because I'm more braver than Matt is, it's because I tend not to be as cautious as Matt is, which can be a downfall.
Kinda, just want to see what's so good.
Yeah, you can film it.
Cool, we'll go on that road there.
Now, I'm not sure exactly if the devil was trying to play some kind of weird, sick game with Matt or me, but it seemed like something was trying to pull Matt away from the fence, and I almost reluctantly gave in as well. But I was persistent, and I felt very committed to going forward. And I told Matt that I wanted to take a picture of the Great Ottawa Wall for the future.
It's like, I'm not gonna lie, it's a little depressing to see that, that this is...
There was also a very dark spirit around this area, considering I've been down at the Ottawa protest several times, and every time I've been down there, there's been this overall feeling of joy. I've never felt this way unless I've been in church.
What it came to be?
Yeah, before there's a big vibe.
Yeah. Now look at the vibe. It's like homeless building. Huh? Very sad. Actually, I should record some of that.
Thank God we did go down that path because we ended up bumping into some other believers in Christ, which is a great blessing, as you will see in a few seconds, that the girl named Alexander, which by the way is not her real name, just because I don't know if she wants me to provide that real name. Anyways, she was from the Ottawa area and recognized Ottawa's police chief, Steve Bell, which allowed me to rebuke him hard, and I called him out to repentance to Christ.
I'm trying to. But
so right here, she has just approached us, and she must have seen Matt carrying his Bible. And we told her that we were here to preach the good word to the police officers.
Oh, I love it.
Yeah.
You came prepared.
Well, we're gonna preach the gospel here to the cops, man.
Yes.
Yeah, we've been here a couple times, and they confiscated our gas because we're trying to bring it to them, and we're like, that's okay.
Yeah.
And you know what? And so we're like, do you know what the gospel is? Oh, well, you know, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, oh, that's okay. So we start preaching it.
The great thing about being a believer in Christ is that you can come up to any other fellow believer in Christ and just automatically start talking like your long lost friends. It is an incredible enjoyment to have this bond. We were just telling her a story about us getting our gas compensated by the Ottawa police that took place about 2 weeks before this filming took place. I'm going to go ahead and show you that incident. If you don't want to watch it, just go ahead and fast forward it.
We'll at one point count for it.
Yeah,
everybody here, doesn't matter who it is, we're all sinners.
Yeah, everybody.
No one's righteous.
There's not one person's righteous.
Yeah.
The gospel is repentance. You know, you turn your life to Christ.
No, they're stealing our diesel. But that's okay, I got more of it. So if they confess it, I'll just come back.
Oh, and I definitely did come back, and I did give some diesel to a Christian truck driver. Take that, A41.
Yeah, we put it on YouTube too. We appreciate you doing it.
At this point, Matt was starting to pull out his piece of paper to read to the one lady cop that I have seen her actually on a couple of reports after the fact, and she doesn't seem to be a very nice police officer. One incident remember her by was her trying to break into a restaurant or a cafe place.
Share this out, you guys. Get it out everywhere. Now, get it out. They're saying they're going to break the window. They already walked around back, you guys, so.
So I was quite surprised when I saw this happening in the news, because our interaction with these people wasn't anything highly stressful per se. I mean, they did seem very authoritarian, and when we did challenge them on their rights to steal our gas, they definitely did push back, saying that it was a valid order, which we clearly rebuke to them, and we definitely rejected their stance on what they thought was lawful. To make long story short, at the end of this video clip, we did shake hands with the individuals, and the cop did, or the sergeant did, say that he understands why people are there fighting for their rights, and he does not want his rights taken away. But then when I saw, he clearly is not being honest. And also, I can understand why that gentleman did not want to open up the store for those police officers, because at the end of near the end of this clip, I will point it out here. Listen to what he says to me about arrest or maybe possibly being beaten up.
No, well,
I'm gonna preach the gospel to you, okay? Pardon? That's okay. It's out of love. Okay, I don't hate you. I just want to preach the gospel to you. The gospel is the call is to repentance of sins, to turn from wickedness, love your God with all your heart, your mind, and your soul, and your brothers and your sisters, to believe in accordance with.
You point out, unfortunately, my brother's camera, the phone that we were using, he never likes to charge it, and at that critical moment, while he was preaching the gospel to the officer, the phone died. So that's too bad.
You're gonna give us something. Don't worry about it. You're gonna give us something.
Do you know the video center is open?
Nope.
Oh, so you can answer questions.
So when I tell her that, oh, you can answer questions, it's because she didn't want to answer any of our questions, but somebody had passed by and asked her if the Rito Center was still open, and that's when she charmed up and said, nope.
Well, you think that giving a ticket out or something would be an easy situation, but we have how many police officers?
Old-time religion.
Give me that.
Old-time religion is good enough for me. It was good for Paul and Silas. It was good for Paul and Silas. It was good for Paul and Silas. It's good enough for me.
Now give me that.
Old-time religion.
Give me that.
Old-time religion.
Give me that.
Old-time religion is good enough for me.
So in the interaction between me and the police officers, I did originally wanted to be arrested, but obviously they weren't going to do that. And I also requested for them to give me a ticket, which they also rejected. They really didn't want to take any of my information down, except for the fact that we were persistent in the fact that we wanted our gas back. So the gentleman did take our names. He only really wanted it to be vocal. However, we persisted in giving him our names through a piece of paper.
To my risk, and you guys wanted to take it and I refused to, you guys would have to arrest me, right?
Correct.
But if that's what I want, then we have no issue there.
Why would you want to be arrested?
Well, for the glory of Christ, to help my neighbor? Absolutely.
Yeah, and this is a worthy cause.
Absolutely.
You guys don't see this as a worthy cause.
And this is definitely a better way to get a message across outside of being arrested?
I don't think he saw the ironic part of that. Yeah, it's called protesting.
We don't want to do that.
You just claimed that you said something about the gospel before. The entire New Testament is about people who were sacrificed because they stood up to preach the gospel. And like, that's the Epistle Paul. I mean, like...
I'll grab your...
He really did not want to hear the gospel message just because he knew what he was doing was wrong.
First name.
Oh, yeah. It's, it's Tim
sure.
Fearns.
Yeah. No problem.
Yeah, I have dyslexia, so it's hard for me to remember things.
I got it.
Like I did say before, this gentleman was relatively respectful to me and Matt.
I just figured I'd write it all down.
we're getting names right now, so you're welcome to film, but it's more personal. I'll just get you to take a step back.
There was an Israel visual who was standing around to film the interaction. Maybe he was waiting for some kind of scuffle or something so he can post it on YouTube. I'm not really sure, but the officer wasn't too impressed with somebody filming it, even though everybody was. And I had jumped in, told the individual or the cop that it was perfectly fine for him to film me.
He can film, yeah.
Okay, well, it's fine. It's more for your privacy. It doesn't bother me.
You're welcome to film, my friend. Okay,
great.
Yeah.
Sometimes people post videos, and I just didn't want your name on social media.
I don't care. I get kicked off of social media all the time because I preach the gospel, so it's okay. That's awesome.
Not that it's like I said,
it's all glory to God.
Yeah.
I mean, that's why we're trying to show our love for our neighbor to help out a good, worthy cause.
Yeah.
I know maybe your conscience is trying to suppress it to make it seem like it's not a worthy cause. But that's all Romans 1.
The nation coming up and going like, true to what Trudeau's doing is wrong. I mean, that kind of should say you might want to start thinking about,
Tim, do you have a phone number?
I do have a phone number.
Yeah, so he really didn't want to hear it at all, which is too bad because after seeing some of the videos of him beating up protesters, it's a shame that he didn't take the message a little bit more serious. What are you to expect? When you teach people they come from animals, they're going to act like animals.
And I'll give you my wife's number, because I never answer my phone.
That's okay. It's more just, like, if we ever had to reach you by...
Well, I mean, like, okay, well, I guess it'll come up as OPP or Ottawa Police,
it
right?
It may be a block number, but if you have a message, we'll leave a message. That's not
yeah, but the problem is I never check my messages. But, okay, well, whatever.
Maybe
I will give you my wife's number.
For us to get the gas cans back, you guys will do that later on, I guess, or something.
Correct.
So do we get like a receipt from you guys or something?
We don't have receipts. That's why I'm documenting.
Oh, I see. Okay.
And I'm happy to give you my contact.
Oh, perfect. Perfect. That's great.
If I can write on a.
Yeah, absolutely, right on there. That's
sure.
Fine.
Yeah, that'd be great. Okay, so next time not to give you the guy's gas can.
Now listen to what this individual says. I find it very fascinating and also a little scary, since now I know what the officers were going to do with the protesters. Their plan was never to arrest law-abiding citizens, because they obviously knew we were all law-abiding citizens, even though they disagree with what we were protesting against. Or maybe they agreed, I don't know. Point is, listen to what he says. He says something like, you know, because I was talking to him about how I would show up next time with fuel, but this time I would chain it to me. And he basically says, you know, that you don't want to do that. And it implies that things could escalate where you might get beat up, because at first I thought he was talking about me getting arrested, but that's not what he implies. So just listen to it.
Gentlemen, the whole purpose is to ensure safety, right?
Well, we're not trying to cause any issues.
I understand the safety concern, but
if you refuse to obey a lawful order,
it's not a lawful order.
It ends up escalating, and I can assure you, we want to ensure your safety as much as you want to ensure everybody else's.
We've heard the word
right?
safety now for the last 2 years.
Yeah.
What does that mean nowadays, right?
Yeah. Well, we refer to physical safety.
Well, it's okay. I'm okay of being roughed up or whatever. It's perfectly fine. I'm not afraid of it.
Right. And I'm not saying you are, but we don't want to do that.
I wouldn't resist, so I don't know why would there be any forceful.
So that ends that little segment. I'm going to return back to the segment where we were just meeting the fellow Christian believers, and we will continue with that scene.
Oh yeah, this has God all over it.
It really does.
It has, like, everybody, you know, even with.
So this little segment, you'll hear us talking a bit. If you don't want to listen to it, you can go ahead and fast forward it. But this is probably the reason why you are watching in the first place, is to hear what we were talking about in the first place. So enjoy.
The unbelievers out here, that there's something in them that's telling them to get down here and just, you know, this is a bigger movement, because I think it has everything to do with when Trudeau finally said, he came out with that bill C-4 and said, oh, God's a mythology. 2 weeks later, and God says, I will not be mocked.
Yeah.
You know, and look at this, he's a laughing joke around the world.
It's true.
Yeah. Yeah.
So do you guys know how to get there?
We're trying to, we came in from another way yesterday.
Okay. Were you here, guys, yesterday?
We were at their end.
Yeah.
Because they had police bank.
Oh, okay. Well, honestly, you know what I just did? We just went around, did all the back ways to up to Vanny, and I was afraid that they're going to have a checkpoint there, and I was like, well, whatever. So I'm like, he was like all panicking, and I was like, you know what? We're just going to go right up to the checkpoint. And I just went into that and told the cops, I'm just here to preach the gospel. Okay. Yeah. It's hilarious. It's too bad it's kind of cold, but.
Are
you guys going to go this way?
Yeah.
This was a great blessing to me and Matt to bump into these wonderful people, because we're not very good at navigating very well. So we tend to get lost very easy. And so it was a great blessing that we found these people, and we tagged along with them to eventually end up to the position where we end up preaching to a group of RC, Royal Canadian Mounted Police.
I don't think we can get
there. Oh, okay. Yeah, I'll go that way. Well, I was just going to go there and document it, but that's okay. We'll try this way then. So are they here to preach the gospel? Or?
I think so.
Yeah.
This is where Alexandra was talking to her mother and her friend, and me and Matt were end up talking to ourselves because we were wondering if they were here to preach the gospel too. But I think they were talking to each other because they had noticed Steve Bell, the police chief of Ottawa. I did not recognize him. But you'll see that in the video.
Oh yeah.
Who, him? Yeah, I just heard that he might have been down too.
I wouldn't be surprised.
He's in his uniform.
So that's him?
You need to repent.
Sir, you need to repent. You need to turn to Christ. What you're doing is sinful and wrong. The
call is to repent of your sins.
No one is righteous.
Not one.
$100,000
Now, Matt and the other ladies weren't too sure what this guy said, but I believe he was just saying, if you want to make $100,000 a year, go be a fascist, something like that. So you'll end up hearing Matt and the ladies talk a little bit about that.
I don't think so.
I don't know. Was he
what? Was Cornwall?
I don't think he was. I think he was serious.
What?
I don't know.
Oh, really? We'll pray for you, sir!
I really did want to say more to Steve Bell, but nothing was coming to my mind. So I believe the only thing that I was able to tell him was the call of repentance and just simply say we'll pray for him. Thank you for watching part one. I will have part two up in the next couple of days. If you like what me and Matt are doing, and if you wish to help us preach the gospel to police officers in the future, if you want to help us to do this, you can always check out our store, and you can take a look at some of our wood carvings that we do. We will have a more of a bigger selections in the weeks and months to come. And all I can say right now is God bless you and have a terrific day.
It will do when I am dying. It will do when I am dying. It's good enough for me.
Give me that
old-time religion.
Give me that
old-time religion.
Give me that
old-time religion. It's good enough for me.